Alright, well, the mission fails. Here we're back to our quick pick map routine again. This is JP August quick pick map with the map may come closer or later in global depend on how early the grab closure situation is. This time though, Alaya is just everywhere. It is even more so than before. Because the map has buff AoE leases for everyone by 30, nothing beats her 3 ST punch to the ground. The lightning element are the most popular team in the game right now as top of the food chain. However, we are still having score incoming too. So I don't know what they are thinking. In my opinion, I feel like water and ice are just as strong now, but water lose lightning and ice are kinda never much popular, despite their hidden potential. Anyway, I won't repeat this again, but Alaya 3 multi ST hit are cheat in this Kaya blue. The map is as following picture. One side can spawn 3 together, another side requires separation. The beginning position determines much of the outcome, because you may have the team with advantage against faster turn or slower turn. Glacella and Edward are especially good for 1 turn buff, whereas Alaya prefer 2 turn buff. My team is bare minimum for the reincarnation count, so my Alaya has to choose between maximize her accuracy to fend against evade or increase a bit of HP to lessen the pressure when I gotta play up against many JP Mag reincarnation Alaya, who might also come with full stack lightning element buff. In early battle, I use team A, realizing not so many evades are in play, so I go with team B later first. Glacella could easily tank 5 evades and she has sure hit also, so I only have to be worried about my reality light evade team, who is there to counter the regular lightning meta of Alphonse, Helena, and Alaya, low accuracy build especially. These three are really popular, considered as a counter team against late mate set I mentioned before in previous video. So basically this game is just like this, a counter against a counter, which is also against another counter. Sometimes they just look bad to make all unit like Elena becoming good again, since she deal ST magic damage, which is good against Glacella, increasing chain count, and she can evade lightning team with few pressure against Miller Matt until they sacrifice their own accuracy in exchange for small chunk of stun gain. All of their sure hit are on tank first, unlike Edward of the Fridge. Alright, without further ado, let's begin our match. Oop! It seems we see a similar effect here. Alright, I can guess that he probably go with the lightning meta or Fridge one, but he's likely going with the lightning version. Yeah, because that is Helena right there. Alright, it's on spot. Oh my god, did Odeba max his reincarnate on Alaya already? So my Alaya is 9k, but his is 12k, that is 3k HP or above different. Oop, that hurt. My Glacella almost get one shot, but she has guard anyway. For this is AoE attack, maybe not hurt so much on Edward. My Alaya is fully buffed. Now it's about Glacella. Okay, good. Defense penetration down. That definitely helped a bit ago. Now it's a counter time. We have Fish VC advantage, which is stronger by a bit on DP sec, but it is very tight button it seems. Oh, alright, this is AoE attack, but it's reduced lightning resist by a lot. Okay, I think I win this with the Blowfish final attacker. That was a wonderful fight. By the way, this is the first time I met with Odaiba in pickup mat, I think, because well, everyone now start with Diamond 1, and we always end up with the Diamond Master. I usually stop my fight after I reach Diamond Master because there is no further reward after that. And then we all begin at the same start again, each of the month. So yeah, there are more chance that we would meet similar fate now. But the poor people getting Diamond Master are become more and more, so it's not easy to meet. Okay, it seems that I am lured away, so it's quite far, to be honest. Yeah, my Alaya can't hit any one of them. Okay, but my Edward could get a good following up. Oop, that hurt a lot. My Casella died without getting cut. That's bad. Okay, lightning destroy the guard, yeah, that is good thinking. Good situation for when you are dealing with relays and guard. That following attack is quite strong. I wonder if they're gonna go with dark, yeah, as expect. Not many people shoot dark right now, but I think he's getting forced to use dark here. At least they have strike resistance, because he probably know that I'm going to use fist team too. But as I mentioned before on my meta analysis, I know that dark no longer hold possibility to win against my fish meta, because after Alaya has arrived, you're gonna need more than one unit strongly resist against fish. Yeah, you see what happened here? Because of the multi ST attack on my team, all of three characters I used here have multiple target lock. And this is the situation of the tank without aura protection friend. I mean, what can Lab do? Lab can tank, right? But we aren't exactly only hit Lab. We are hitting Daddy Psyc at the same time because of the multi target lock. And this is how fish team becomes strong. Basically, we don't care about that tank. Even if that tank has a lot of resistance, we just kill their partner first. So, the way they can deal with my team here is just to do similar to that lightning team. A while ago, lightning team stay far away from me and they split out. Oh, okay, this team are splitting out too. That is the way to deal with my team. Because if they split out far enough, then I'm exactly forced to attack tank only. But if they are not far enough, the AI will always find the situation where they can hit more than one target. Now they are all starting to group together, so my Alaya can get in. I bet it's gonna be similar, that Lav will be the last to stay again. Yeah, we don't care about tank, so maybe you can get better chance to not use tank at all against multi-lock team like this. Wow, this Lav is so tanky. Actually, Machuli was also very tanky. I see that Machuri can tank so many of its fish. I thought Machuri would get down a lot sooner than that. But yeah, eventually, it's only remained just a tank, so they can do nothing against it. I think they're probably gonna go dark or ice, of course, but which one? That ice team is kind of old, a bit outdated, but don't know. I never test a match against them before, so I cannot know what will happen here. Alaya Gunner also get upgraded not long ago. Her EX to make her first bite has more chance to trigger. Oop. Damn, that is strong. Maybe my Grasselle isn't so tanky again. Missile after all. Especially ST attack missile. Oh damn, my Grasselle down so quick. Now we only have DPSec left. If they combo rapidly shoot, we might doom. Ah, but Elisa get one shot. Yeah, they are soon to die. This team, this could be either lightning or water. A well team, I see. Well water team. That Penny has 14k HP. Gazella has 15k HP. This 15k HP Gazella mean that she is Mac Lycanet already. 14k should be Mac Lycanet Penny also. But I think Penny Lycanation that end 2 weeks ago was really sad a bit. I think that Pene is now at the third spot for water element team, so she are getting kicked out soon, at the next 3 months maybe. Oh, this team is so tanky, you see what happened here, right? My Araya keep attacking and they are not down. Maybe I will lose on this one, because my Grasselle already down, they still stay. And I get defense penetration down on my team also right now. This is bad situation now. I need to kill that tank quickly. Or kill that DPSec. Alright, that's double hit. Because one good point about Alaya is that the hunt also reduce enemy CT down. So there is a chance just like King Battle where double attack was possible. This one. This one is very risky to me, I may lose. This person is so Ken of the Force. He is probably known strongest person in the game right now. But he isn't exactly rank 1, yeah. But so Ken is, I think, either leader or sub-leader of the strongest guild in the JP server. Oh, this is the first time that I see a mixing between Grasselle and Fish team just like I do. I never see other person do it before in the quick pick map here. But his version is Earth Element against my Edward Wind Element, so I have a bit of advantage. If not talking about how Alaya is weak against Earth and Alaya is the most important DPSec of the team. I think he probably Mac Lycanet every character on his team here, knowing that he is the strongest person potentially in JP server. Yeah, but knowing that his team is similar to me make me a bit happy. Okay, well, I think the bad luck that I have is that his Yuleo is so far from my Edward. My Edward never be able to reach his Yuleo at all, so they start in opposite direction. I may have my chance to win certain known person if Edward can punt that Yuleo girl one or twice. Oh, that is late mate team over there, isn't it? But I have my fire team here, so I don't think he there. By the way, nowadays I only play until Diamond Master and then end the match since I'm little too busy. And it is easy to reach that every month, so the late is just profit and enjoyment. By the way, Vika had high strike leases and therefore stack lightning give them more power. So if I win, it's all thanks to the team comp. My Grasselle can protect my teammate unlike Alaphont that can help his teammate against ST attack. This is so risky. Last punch. Alright. Okay, I can see it's coming next up. The light element evade team, which hold danger to my team right now, since my Alaya is no longer team A set up. Move to set B now, which I trade my accuracy over for HP. Well, I can expect the niche, right? I have to go for majority. And now I'm not sure if my Alaya can hit that evade. Have to see. They cannot go full evade either, I think. Yeah, because if they are going full evade, their DPS gonna reduce too. And they have mixing with Grasselle too. Just like my team, Grasselle gonna make their teammate tanky. Okay, yeah, my Alaya can hit. But I have my Edward, so my team is better than Pure Lightning. Pure Lightning would have more situation problem against evade. Light evade doesn't have sure hit ignore, so my Edward can always hit them. Oh, will this hit or not? Alright, it hit. Lucky me. Yeah, so they can't go full evade either, I think. Oh, my Kalaya. There we go. She finally hit him at the last punt. Okay, this one could be full win or full lightning, but likely full lightning. You can see that win team mostly don't put zoom anymore because the tank is outdated, sadly. I think we need a new tank. Light team also. Oh, okay. They are going fast. They have CT up also. They gonna get more buff than us. They get Balia on board now. Alaphont has full buff now. Alaya also have full buff. My Alaya has full buff too, and I only go with one buff setting, so I'm not worried. Ah, only hit one. Oh, oh my god, they are the first to hit 3 units. Oh, slow. charm. Okay, now I'm gonna return double. What? Why is his Alaya so tanky? Damn, his Alaya is so strong, this team. What? Not least guard yet. This is unusual for Alaya to be such tanky. But yeah, anyway, we lead Diamond Master. That is all for me. Thank you for watching. I hope you have fun and learn something from this. I will be seeing you next time. And if you don't mind, please throw in a super thanks once in a while. I will be really appreciate. Bye bye.